What is up, guys? It is ArrowCod motherfucking Maniac here, and guess what? Yeah, bitch, I'm back, and I bet you some of you guys are like, where have you been, Arrow? Where have you been, Mr. ArrowCod Maniac? It's past your bedtime. Well, I'm going to tell you a nice little story. So, if you guys don't care about the story, you can go ahead and skip to the time that you see on the screen. That is where everything, that's when story time is over. And I got some announcements at the end of the video, so if you would be so kindly to at least watch the announcements at the end, because I have some things I need to explain because of story time. Although, I'm pretty sure you'd be interested in the story time, but if any time during the story you get bored or whatever, skip to that time, make sure you watch the announcements part at the end. Okay, thank you. So, what happened to ArrowCod Maniac? Where have I been for 36-ish days? Okay, first of all, I was hijacked. My account was hijacked. And, a lot of people use the word hacked, and the reason why I'm not going to use the word hacked is because to be a hacker, you kind of have to be a little bit smart. You have to be, you know, you have to have some brainiac skills or some super equipment, some space technology, mumbo jumbo voodoo stuff, and this guy did not have any of that, okay? This kid, he's a kid, okay? And he was not smart. He just used a technique that other people used, okay? It's not smart at all. It's kind of like saying you hack a Wii. You're not smart, bro. You're just using a technique that everybody has a technique for. They've always showed you and whatever. You're not smart. You just, you know, applied a technique that you learned. Anyways, during this time period, some people knew that I was hacked. As you can see on the screen right here, I'm going to show some of the comments that people posted. These people, knew I was hacked because of my Facebook. If you don't have my Facebook, then you wouldn't have known. Here's some comments right here on the screen, showing obviously that these people did not know. A couple of them are funny if you want to look at them. They're pretty funny. If you would like to know how those people knew, you have to add me on Facebook. It's a friendly Facebook, personal Facebook. I talk, you know, about whatever, and if you send me a message on there, I'm pretty sure I'll respond, unless it's something stupid like, "Hey, Earl, will you add me on a PS3? I'm your biggest fan." Well, you know, I can't add you a PS3. I don't play PS3, but, you know, it's just whatever. And, yeah, that's beyond the point. Anyways, add me on Facebook. The link will be in the description if you wish. And, now, let's get into the story time. First of all, I got a message on Skype on May 1st, 2013. It was from a guy named GoPotatoTV, which is the name of my partnership program. Collab, GoPotatoTV, and the McFadden brothers. They run my YouTube channel, my partnership program, excuse me. So they're the one that pays me, they're the ones that, you know, kind of guide me with the partnership and whatever. So that's what happened. I'm new to Skype. I don't use Skype frequently. I did not know that you can change your screen name. I did not know that. So, this guy posed as my partnership program and sent me a message. Here it is on the screen. If you don't want to read it, I'll give you a recap, basically. He's saying, he's asking for my phone number. If you don't know your YouTube password, you're eligible to, when you sign up with YouTube, you put your phone number in. So, if you don't know your password, it says, here, just give us your phone number, and we're going to send a 6-digit code to you. And then you put the 6-digit code in, and then basically, bam, you got your password back. Okay, cool. I didn't know that. Okay, because I'm stupid. So, I made a stupid mistake. I told him my phone number, because he asked for it. And then he said, what's the 6-digit number? And I'm like, oh, okay, it's this, blah, 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 blah. And bam. Okay, so now he was in my account. For those of you who don't know what two-step verification is, it's a security process that YouTube enables. Okay? While he was in my account, I did not have it enabled. But while he was in my account, he enabled it. And he put in his phone number as a backup, and he put in his email as a backup. Meaning, there's absolutely no way I can get back in. Okay, so, this is when I was kind of like, alright, this is not cool. So, I got kicked out, I realized it, we went to dinner as a family, and I was just kind of quiet the whole time. I was thinking about everything. I was like, did I really just get hacked? Did this really just happen? Hijacked, excuse me. I was like, did this really just happen to me? So, when I got home, I stayed pretty late, and I started studying every single trace of information this little kid left. Okay, so, here's what I came across. So being new to Skype, I figured out that you can actually view profiles. So I looked at his profile, and here it is on the screen. You can see his Skype information. I'm not going to block that shit out. You guys can redhead if you want to Skype him, go for it. I found his YouTube channel. Wait, don't Skype him or don't message him or whatever until the end of this video, okay? I want you to watch the full thing, and then I'm going to actually tell you what to do afterwards if you'd like to. So, yeah, so anyways, okay, so I found his Skype information, and I found his Facebook page. Ooh, look at Jake Kennedy. He's a little kid. I found his YouTube channel, which is the King's Consul HD, which has about 3,000 subscribers, but I think that might not be his. I think it might have been another channel that he stole, and I'll get to that in a future point in this video. But for now, that's his YouTube channel. And I found some of his friends that he has. Dazernator, who is Yop, and I was kind of exploring because I was unsure if I was really, really hijacked at this point. So I left for the night. I fell asleep. Woke up and I asked my mom, "What should I do? What would be the best thing to do?" And she says, "Well, notify your partnership program." So I was like, "Okay." So I created a new YouTube account. I messaged my YouTuber partner guy. His name is James, so I'm gonna call him James for now on. I messaged him. I said, "Hey, you didn't happen to message me on Skype because I think I just got hijacked." You know, I was kind of shocked. So he messaged me, said no, but email me now and we'll get this settled. So I emailed him on my email and we started conversing and learning stuff. While that was happening, you're able to, you know, do this whole "I didn't change my password, someone's in my account" kind of Google form thing that you're allowed to fill out. So I started filling that out, and this is May 2nd now, and I started filling that out, and it said it's going to be sent to me within 3 to 5 business days, okay? So, during that time, I started watching, I'm going to refer to ArrowCodManiac as ArrowCodManiac, because I'm not ArrowCodManiac anymore in this point of the video. So when you hear ArrowCodManiac from now on, I'm talking about whoever has control over my account, okay? So, I started watching ArrowCodManiac's channel comments, and I began learning the hijacker's friends. So, I learned there was Dazernator, and there was some other guy, T.E., there was, you know, a whole bunch of his hacker friends that do the same thing. So, I saw Dazernator, and Dazernator in ArrowCodManiac's channel comments were saying, who's teaching him how to do this glitch to permanently keep me out of my channel. And I was like, what? So I clicked on his channel and started reading about Dazernator. Turns out this guy does the same thing. He captures people's channels the same way that Zilla did, or same way the hacker did, sorry. And he sells them. I'm like, yo, that ain't cool, bro. That is that cool. So I started reading stuff, blah, 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 blah. I told James about him, and, you know, that was kind of it. Around May 5th-ish, maybe, the hacker who had my account, the hijacker who had my account, he actually listed a feature channel under the feature channel subbox thing on ArrowCodManiac channel. And that channel's name was Zilla. Zilla is the hijacker. Because if you look back on the Skype information that I showed you, Zilla has his name, you know, that's his like code name or whatever that he has on there. That's his name, so that's Zilla. So I was like, okay, so Zilla is a hijacker. That's official, obviously, but that, you know, that's confirmation. So now, you know, I kind of just needed to confirm that, you know, Zilla was the King's Consul HD, so whatever. Alright. Zilla messaged me on Skype. He taunted me a couple times, and I'll show you right here on screen what he started saying to me. I'm sorry if, by the way, I am sick, and I am kind of out of breath because I don't know if you noticed, but I paused the audio a couple times because I have to go yell at the family or take the cat out or whatever if you can hear them in the background. And now they don't listen to me anyways. Okay, alright. So, he started taunting me, if you could read the messages that you see on the screen again. He's basically just saying, "Oh, how do you like your new name?" Or, "I uploaded a video for you," or whatever, you know. Like, stupid shit. He didn't really do anything bad to my account until I was able to get back into my account on May 9th. May 9th, I got a message from Google Support at 2 in the morning, and it said, "If you would like to reset your password, click this button." I was like, oh my gosh, I think I'm getting back into my account. Oh my gosh, yes. So I click it, reset password, put my own password in, checked my recovery options, it said all my stuff. I was like, okay, cool, bro, righteous. And I was happy. I read all my comments. He didn't he didn't read any of the comments for some reason. He left them all unread. So I had like 66 unread in those 8 days. And then he didn't send any messages either, which is kind of weird. But yeah, so I briefly fixed my channel and I looked through my Gmail. Looking through my Gmail, I found the messages that he sent to YouTube staff saying he changed my name from ArrowCodManiac with a capital D to ArrowCodManiac with a lowercase d. I don't know why he did that, what that, you know, did or whatever, but that's just what he did. Another thing I found out that he unpartnered me with GoPotato, which is Colab. He unpartnered me with Colab and repartnered ArrowCodManiac with RPM Network. You know why he did that, right? That means now he's getting paid for the videos that I did. And that's not something I want him to do, you know? So, I started looking through my YouTube stuff. Again, he didn't read the comments. He didn't respond to any messages. But he did upload a video saying that he hacked me. He quickly took it down. I never got to see the video. I never got to watch it. Although some of you guys did, because when I was in my Gmail, I was able to check the messages and check some of you that commented. I saw a couple comments, about 5 of them, and most people, some people thought it was a joke, some people thought that was my way of saying I'm done with YouTube, and some people thought it was real. Okay, so anyways, I fell asleep happy that night, and I woke up to find out that somehow he got back into the account. I did not know how, but he did. I still don't know how. On May 14th, he uploaded a video that got lots of hate. As you can see, there was a huge dislike video, dislike ratio, and he deleted every single comment stating that it was a fake or a hacker or whatever. And then he made comments awaiting approval to be uploaded. So, yeah, he did not, you know, he was kind of covering himself up. And I now have enabled every comment to be visible. So if you'd like to see those comments, you can go to the video. That video is going to be deleted on June 7th, if this video is uploaded on the 6th. If not, it's just going to be one day after this video is posted. So if you'd like to read those, but if not, you know, whatever. You can see there's a lot of ones that he did not confirm. And I've allowed them all to be shown now so you could read all the comments that people are saying. And anyways, this kind of stuff happened until May 22nd. I kept filling out that Google form again, and on May 22nd, I got a call from James. I talked to James a lot, by the way. I got a call from James and a guy from YouTube staff. His name is Alex, and I'm very thankful for James's help, by the way. James, nonstop, literally, guys, literally nonstop, helped me with this channel. He was on it every single day. We'd message each other, email, text, call, whatever. He was always there, and he helped like a shitload, guys. I cannot explain. So I talked to Alex, the YouTube staff member, and then I talked to James, and we kind of just got in a phone call. I kind of was irresponsibly halfway, you know, mentally in the phone call because I had so much stuff going on in real life. I was walking, I had problems, whatever. So anyways, so I was happy that, you know, I talked to Alex. It kind of brightened up my mindset. I thought, you know, my channel's coming. So eventually, June 5th 2013, which is right now when I'm recording it, but you should be seeing this on June 6th, I was able to sign back into my account. I got the reset password option, and I'm finally back in. Hopefully I can upload this video tomorrow on June 6th, without waking up to him having my account, you know? So, anyways, going through my Gmail and stuff, I was able to track some IP addresses that were in my account, thanks to Alex at YouTube for telling me that I could do this. So I did check out previous IP addresses that were on this account, found out that there was a transfer of IP addresses on May 21st from Ireland to a new location. If you guys remember on the Skype info, here it is again. Turns out Zilla lives in Ireland. On May 21st, it went from Ireland to somewhere else. I'm not going to show you the IP address screen because I don't want you guys doing anything, because I know some of you tech people out there can do something, but I'd prefer you not to. So I'm not going to show you that stuff. But I think that means that he sold my channel on the 21st. So that means he sold my channel. And basically, he was trying to make money off of my videos. So that's pretty much all I could say about the story time. I know this video was a very long video, and it was kind of hard. It, you know, it was kind of a little whatever, off track and kind of irritating to listen to my sick voice. I'm sorry. The gameplay, I don't even know what gameplay I'm putting up for this. I'm really honestly, I don't know. I'm recording over nothing. But now for the updating stuff. So here we are. Hello, people who skipped through this story time thing. Welcome to, you know, after story time announcements. Okay, so what I have to say is, first of all, I have pre-made a bunch of videos. For my 700 video originally, I was going to post a moving vlog, because I moved houses, okay? So I have an entire vlog of me moving, okay? I was going to post that on May 2nd, sorry, and I never got to post it, along with a whole bunch of other videos, so I have some videos that I have to post. Not too many, maybe about 6 I'm looking at right now, I'm just scanning zombie U stuff. I'm going to be doing some live commentaries, live commentaries, regular commentaries, and I'll try doing some glitch stuff. Basically, expect to see a lot of ripped off videos from the King's Console HD, because I got a lot of his videos, and I'm remaking a lot of them with Radiation, or Wozni, or Kool-Aid Van, or whoever decides to be with him. You know, I'm basically ripping off his videos, because, you know, kind of fuck you, because you took my shit. So, anyways, yeah, so that's that. Now, some of these videos are outdated. Like, I made a live commentary, and that will probably be up, you know, in a couple days. I do mention in that video, by the way, that TDM should be plus 150. And, you know, I made this video looking at it right now. I made it way back in April 27th. Okay, so April 27th. It's been a while since I made that video. I was ready to upload that thing. At that time, there was no Arms Race or whatever it's called on Xbox. There was none of that. So I didn't know what I was talking about. So that was before. Again, I do have a glitch video. I have Call of Duty Gone Wrong 21, I think it is. I have Pick a Gun Episode 2. I have a new series coming out called Last Hope. It's going to have a plot, a character development. I'm not very happy with how Episode 1 turns out, but don't let that catch you off guard, because if you follow the series, you'll be able to understand the character development. It gets into a really good plot. It should be about 5 episodes, maybe 4 or 5, and the ending is going to kick ass, okay? So, hopefully you do enjoy the new intro, by the way. Also, guys, before I go, I want you guys, if you want to, message Zilla. His YouTube channel will be in the description below. I want you to message him, or Skype him, or Facebook him, or whatever it is that you wish to contact him by, and just link him to this video. Just be like, present from Arrow, and then link the video. That would be so awesome, okay? Alright, you can do that, and then, if you want to. And, what else was there? There's something else. Oh, yes, I did get a new computer. It's very nice, although it did, kind of, you know, make me broke, so, I'm very broke right now, and my HD PVR is, not working. The cord is not working for this, so I can't record gameplays, or videos, or anything, really. So, all I have is these pre-made videos that I have, so, once I upload those, and if I still don't have my cord in the mail yet, then we're kind of screwed. Okay, so, you know, we have, maybe about a week or two left until I'm completely out of videos and stuff. But once I get that back in the mail, then hopefully that'll work with my PVR. I pray to God that it will. And then if it does, then bam, you know, poof, we're good. Alright, I think that's pretty much it. I don't want to leave anything out, but anyways, if I do, sorry for the long video. I know this must have been terribly, terribly boring, but if it wasn't, then cool. Alright, guys, so glad to be back. And love you all, right? Toodles. Hardpoint contested. UAV inbound. Hardpoint contested. You have disgraced yourself.